Just a little while. My contact phone number, you can call right now, is U.S. code 1-843-701-5053. Did you get that? Well, give it to you just a second. You can call. Let me just tell you one other thing that I think will help you. If you could just get to the internet, wherever, get in your home, get on your phone, wherever, get to the internet and go to our website. Our website is located under Overcomer Ministry. Just search on the internet for the Overcomer Ministry. And then on our webpage, you will see pictures of our farm, our tabernacle, our radio schedule, and how you can contact me by email, personally, how you can keep informed. If you would just seek, he that seeks will find, our overcomerministry.org on the internet will give you all the information that you need in reference to understanding what God has us doing here on this broadcast. Overcomerministry.org. Call right now with your questions, your comments, your opinions, and even your contentions. I listen to them all. I'm the only one that listens to the call, and I respond accordingly. The phone number to call is U.S. code 1-843-701-5053. Maranatha.
Nothing else will help. Love lives in me. Those in danger, look above.
Jesus. Once to be, be saved. And I've never had her ever say so many times, I love you, Dad. Which invokes, I love you too. Because we're going to conquer and overcome by the power of God's grace and God's love. Praise the Lord. God bless you, Brother Brown. You keep pressing and keep running. We shall overcome. You listen to the overcomer? The two calls that came in have come from people right here, Brother Brown and I believe a sister, one of two of our sisters, they call, listening here on the farm. The phone number is US code 1-843-701-5053. I remember what came across me today as I sat here for several hours listening to the news. The tornado that demolished the Nashville area. The war that's breaking out in the midst of so-called peace talks. The fear and anxiety that's sweeping across this country with this alarm on this new virus. Now, remember how I spoke in the prophecy. You'll have diseases that we won't know a thing about. You know, when I start quoting to you the prophecy, I really get a little upset because people will say to me, you've never prophesied anything. Well, one thing I have prophesied, I prophesied that Jesus Christ is coming in your lifetime. And who? I told you that when I die, Christ will come. Now, it won't take long now, much longer anymore, because my time of dying is near. However, we have some time here, and I'm still alive, and so I talk about it as I'm preparing to die. That's what old-fashioned Christianity is all about. It don't prepare you to live. It prepares you to die. Just recently, we buried a sister who was with us here for over 18 years. And what a joy after she laid and suffered for quite a while and waited upon her. But every time you talk to her, she said, I'm going to die. Isn't that something? How can anybody talk like that? Everybody else said,
to the Overcomer Radio broadcast and the voice of the last day prophet of God, the prophet sent by God to preach the coming of Jesus Christ to the whole world and to every nation. Today, now, Walterboro, South Carolina, and the zip code is 29488. Our contact telephone number that you can call any hour of the day, 24 hours a day, you just dial US code 1-843-701-5053. Once again, US code 1-843-701-5053. Our website is very informative. If you have access to the internet, just go to www.overcomerministry.org. You can actually listen to the Overcomer off of the website all the time. You can go to our contact page, and there you can make contact with me by an email address. The website is www.overcomerministry.org. Stay with the Overcomer. Hear the prophet of God. And prepare to meet your God. Maranatha.
We're going to get cancer, and it's going to reprieve, and we're going to live a little longer. But here is someone who God got ready to die. Oh, hallelujah. So if you don't die, you won't live again. If a man dies in Christ, he will live again. Now that's the language that the world doesn't know a thing about. If you haven't heard the prophecy, you need to listen to it because it is coming to the full, coming to completion. This is the last time. This is the last time. And my name is Brother Stair, the voice that's being heard now on many short waves and radio stations on the internet, on the telephone, all over the world. That's right. all over the world.
Hey, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you, great man of God. God bless you. We thank God for the wonders and signs and miracles God is using you all over the world. The whole world knows that you are the true prophet of God. The whole world knows it. Whether they like it or not, they believe it or not, 700% of them don't believe. 700% of this, only 300% believe. But that does not change. They didn't believe now. They didn't believe now, but the work of God was materialized. God did what he wanted to do through Noah. Likewise, God is going to do what he wants to do through you. Now, this is my name is Chris, Pastor Chris, from Nigeria, West Africa. By the special grace of God, I will try to be there for the Passover, April 8 to April 15. I will try to be there by the special grace of God. Presently, I am residing, I'm visiting in Brooklyn, New York. Brooklyn, New York. But by the special grace of God, I will try to be there for the Passover. April 8 to April 15. The word of God will surely come to pass. He said, heaven and earth will pass away, but not a single of his word will come unfulfilled. Every word you have spoken through the mouth of God, through the mouthpiece of God, through the messenger of God, God has been speaking through you. For over 40 years, every word will not come unfulfilled. It will come to pass. That is the word of God. The word of God. That is the word of God. The word of God will not fall to the ground. Like I said earlier, 70% of them don't believe. But they will see the truth of God will fall upon them. In Jesus' mighty name. Pastor Chris. Pastor Nike. Brooklyn, New York. I'm from Nigeria, West Africa. We're visiting Brooklyn, New York. God bless you. God bless you, man of God.
The past 40 years, as the Father said, we have spoken to this generation. The word of the Lord, the coming of Christ. The word of God is truly on its final test. Every word of God is true. The judgment of God upon this world is absolutely astonishing and amazing. This is the Overcomer broadcast, heard every hour of every day throughout all the nations of the world, constantly been doing this for many years. This past week, we have been inundated with pros and cons, condemnations, judgments, and it makes no difference how you try to tell the people how God has ordained this ministry. And the only way you can do that is to ordain the minister, the sign. So many people talk to me scriptures, and they act like I don't even know them. I know them. I know what the Bible speaks about true prophets and false prophets. I know that. And I've got to constantly search my own heart and seek God to make sure I'm not preaching the wrong message. I can't preach a man, because the man is man, flesh is flesh. But the word of God is spirit, is true, and it goes forth. I don't get too many calls like that brother from Nigeria, but I get enough of them to strengthen me in my perseverance that God's given me. I often tell these critics, I'm 86, soon to be 87 years old, and God has sustained me in the most supernatural way. in the midst of Babylon of religion and politics and economic understanding, a generation that knows everything just don't know God. The reason I'm on here again today with what I call an insert that I put into our broadcast that goes out constantly is to see if I can stir up a few who will take time to call me and let me know that you are listening. Now, information is vital as I use it to direct the broadcast to certain areas to make sure that people do hear it. We thank the call to come in from New York every night, and no reason why the people in the Northeast or New York area cannot hear us. We're on 620 every night from 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock. We're on WWVA every night from 12 to 2. And well, there's so many different areas and shortwave, 30 or 40 frequencies every single day. If you are listening today, are you hearing my announcement concerning the coming Passover? As we get closer to that time, the intensity of it weighs upon my spirit. Passover. Oh, how many are going to miss it again this year. We have taken Passover in America in the form of communion services and in churches, synagogues, and we've done exactly what God told us not to do. Eat and drink unworthily, because we don't discern the effect of our spiritual warfare with the body. We're so iniquitous. We have our own. I remember years ago when I would go to certain churches, they wouldn't even let you take communion because they would call it close communion. Give it only to their own people. And this is the way we are today. We take this bread and wine and we do it unworthily because we don't discern the effect of the Spirit of God in dealing with his people throughout the world. We're going to have the Passover here in April, coming up very soon. And right after April, if I'm still around and I stop by, I am going to be here, although every day with me is precarious. As my body is under attack, my spirit is challenged, my heart is bruised, and I don't know how to say it. If I say it like that, you're going to think I'm seeking sympathy, but I'm not. I'm going to finish that which God called me to do. And all these procrastinators, oh, you're God's man. Yes, sir, we believe God raised you up. Then they turn right around and say, now this is what you got to preach, and this is what you got to declare. And I can say to you hundreds of times, God, years ago, if I ever got to this status of known around the world as the prophet, the last day prophet, God said to me, you receive nothing from man. I use the words of the Apostle Paul, where he said how God revealed himself to him and that he was going to use Paul to establish a work, the work of grace, in the midst of law. And he said, I did not confer with flesh and blood. I did not go to Bible schools or seminaries. I went in the woods on my faith before God in trials and testing. I've been in jail. I've been charged falsely. I've been lifted up wrongly. But I have not done wrong. I humbled myself, and I still do, and if I didn't do that, how can you explain how God raised me up? Signs of the time, and more precisely, the sign of the time. Be not ignorant, Paul said, or Peter, of this one thing, a day with the Lord is 1,000 years. 1,000 years as a day. That was the Holy Spirit giving us some perspective so we could find out where we are in time from the creation in the beginning of time. During that period of time, God gave out feast days or cycles. And each one of them are profound as they identify the events that will bring us to the end. Coming up this year, beginning in April, Wednesday, April the 8th, at sunset, ending on Thursday, April the 16th, at nightfall, we will be observing and commemorating Passover. Passover is the first one of the seven feasts of God, or the seven signs of time. Let us pass over onto the other side. So we remember at Passover what God is doing. He's preparing a people to pass over, and of course, the story in the Bible has to do with a storm and the miracle working of Jesus on the water and preparing his people, his brethren, to get over to the other side. To do that, it was required for Jesus to enter into the ship. And my friends, this is Brother Stern. I speak to you. I know you don't listen. I can tell by the letters you write. I can tell by the phone calls you give. A fellow wrote just a little while ago and said, well, I had a dream about the shutting of the door. I've been preaching that God was going to shut the door over 30 years. Hardly anybody in that 30-year period of time actually believes that the door is going to shut. And because I understand time, it is about ready to close. And when once the master, get it now, not the president, not the pope, when once the master, by the Holy Spirit, shuts the door, many will seek to enter, but they shall not be able. We are going to have a special gathering here at Passover. A few people are rendered who will gather here with us, and those all over the world who are prepared now to be with us, whatever means God brings you to do that. Most of you in the United States and Canada, and even in Mexico, or even some of the islands of the sea, could come and be with us right here at Kennedy's, South Carolina, for the Passover, which will come up here very soon in the new year. All right. We will gather here. Many will come stay with us, right here with us, for that period of time. That's coming April the 8th, Wednesday, Thursday, April the 16th. I hope to have the whole community filled. We have many rooms, you know. Yeah, we do. We got houses are ready for people to live in, to move in, as God's going to fill his house. I just urge you, as you listen to me now, that you will start to make amends on the error of your way for delaying and putting things off until you finally got yourself ensnared in such a way that you really don't know how to get loose. However, I will say to you, if you seek the Lord, he will make a way. He will make a way. The mark of the beast is about to take place. The final 3.5 years with Satan in charge will dominate the world. And just a few of this world will be exempt because they're going to be identified with Satan by the mark. And it will take place in economics. And that's where most of us find ourselves snared. Several times throughout the day, I come on the broadcast with what I call an insert. was a curt word directed to those that are interested. That's what I'm doing now, informing you of the coming Passover, the new year will be passed soon, and we need to, as God people, need to realize that we are coming very quickly to the one hour, the manifestation of the man of sin, the revelation of the final hour and the final time. I always like to hear from people who do listen, and that's another reason for this insert, is to invite you to give me a call and let me know you're listening. Now, we're getting calls from quite a few people, some we haven't heard from for years. They seem to be waking up again, and perhaps God will stir our hearts that we will strive together to have oneness in faith and in truth. My contact phone number is U.S. code 1-843-701-5053. That number one more time is the newest number, working number, and it's there for you to call. U.S. call 1-843-701-5053. An answering machine will answer. You can give us your question, your comment, or your contention, and I will properly deal with each and every one as the Lord so leads. Call now, won't you? And God bless you, and plan on being with us at Passover. Maranatha. Now, we need to hear from the few. I'm not looking for the many. I'm looking for the few that will find that place of quiet rest in this time of great stress and tribulation, who will join your spirit with the true Spirit of God and travail with us in this time, in this present time, to endure until the end, which is just a little while. My contact phone number, you can call right now, is U.S. code 1-843-701-5053. Did you get that?